Let me guess how you've ended up here. You have a digital product that maybe needs completing. Maybe it's an app, maybe it's a chatbot, maybe it's a new software idea. There's just one problem. You don't have anyone in-house to do it. But I'm sure you're thinking, that's okay, outsourcing is simple enough, right? Unfortunately, the truth is, outsourcing isn't quite as straightforward as it seems, because the market is so saturated with options. Over the last few years, tons of freelancers on Upwork, Fiverr, or freelancer.com have emerged, opening the floor to a whole new debate. Should you hire a professional development agency or a freelancer? When it comes down to it, working with freelancers or development agencies both have pros and cons. The decision ultimately comes down to your project specifics and what kind of service and support you need. That doesn't make your decision any easier, does it? Well, that's what I figured. So in this video, I'm going to share with you the pros and cons of hiring either a freelancer or a professional development agency. But before we dive into the pros and cons, and before you make any decisions, you need to reflect on a few questions about your project. I would grab a pen and paper and jot down the answers before moving on to weighing up whether you should choose a freelancer or development agency. You ready? Okay, here they are. What vision do you have for your project? How complex is your project? What's your budget? Do you have any internal team members that can work with you on the project? Or do you have anyone with technical expertise within your organization that can help with the development process? If you had answered each of these questions, you can now start to look at your options. All right, let's begin. Let's look at the advantages of freelancers first. Number one, they often have a very specialized skill set. And if you have a niche idea, this could work in your favor. For example, let's just say your software application requires a particularly animated experience for the user. You should consider hiring a developer who has skills in animation. Number two, freelancers generally have far less overheads than professional agencies, so their cost per hour is often cheaper. But this point is entirely subjective. You need to keep in mind that you get what you pay for. And if you end up outsourcing to more than one freelancer, this can quickly run up your costs. Number three, freelancers tend to be able to build their schedule around your needs and priorities with very little limitation other than other projects they might be working on. So their turnaround time might be quicker than an agency and you can directly communicate with them. But if you're not proficient in technology, just remember, you're going to get what you ask for. And in some cases, what you ask for is not what you really want. Then of course, there are a few downsides to hiring a freelancer. Often freelancers can't offer the same quality of work as an agency. This is not necessarily because they don't have the talent, but rather they don't always have access to the abundance of resources an agency might have. It's like looking for a unicorn. Finding someone who's amazing at everything just doesn't exist. They usually have a few key areas that they're very good at. The other thing is that no matter how talented, professional, or committed the freelancer is, there is still a risk that because they're just one person, unexpected things can come up. So if they're sick, or there's a family emergency, your project will get put on hold. Working with a professional agency eliminates this risk, as the team can compensate for the loss of one of their personnel and still meet your deadlines. You also need to be thinking about what happens post-launch. We all know that when it comes down to software development projects, the launch is by no means the end. A freelancer might include some time for post-launch bug fixing in their initial quote, but if the project is too complex, you'll have to pay out of your pocket for additional maintenance. The other risk is your developer might move on to a new project, so they might not even be available to help you with your post-launch maintenance. In which case, you'll either have to start from scratch with a new freelancer, or just wait until your original developer can work with you again. Having said all of this though, freelancers could be a great match if your project has a low budget, or it's a small one-and-done project with a hyper-specialized task, or even non-mission-critical projects. Now let's take a look at the pros of agencies. Number one, the biggest advantage of hiring a professional company is access to an entire multifaceted team that are able to accommodate all of your design, development, and testing needs. This also means that you're likely to get a final product that's far more consistent and polished than if you were to hire several freelancers that weren't working together. Number two, along the same lines as the pro from number one, professional agencies have accumulated experience working together to deliver comprehensive, high-quality projects for their clients. They have a workflow, they can leverage each other's skills and strengths, and they can accurately predict the necessary resources and time required to accomplish your goals. So when you're working on a strict deadline, a professional agency will be much faster at meeting your needs. And number three, generally, it's easier to get in touch with a representative from a development agency if you have questions or concerns. Unlike freelancers who are generally running the show themselves, agencies will likely have multiple lines of communication available to you and a dedicated customer service team who keeps track of these channels. Now, just like the freelancer option, there are a few downsides to consider. The biggest struggle is usually when you're trying to choose an agency. There are so many different app development agencies out there, and not all of them are created equal. So it's hard to know which one is a good fit for you and your specific app development needs. But other than that, to sum it all up, I'd really say you can't compare the two. If you're looking to build something serious, a freelancer on their own won't cut it. And there are quite a few reasons for that. They have to perform so many roles at once, it's nearly impossible to be really good at all of them. And their experience, no matter how big, just doesn't compare to a team. Plus, the lower hourly rate doesn't necessarily guarantee the lower overall cost for your project. And it won't be so easy to scale your project with freelancers. That's not to say there aren't exceptions. As I mentioned earlier, hiring a freelancer can be a practical solution for you if you need to develop something very simple. Or if you've already hired an agency that might lack a specific skill, a remote specialist could complement that team quite well. So those are just a few things to think about. Hopefully this has given you some guidance. If you're ready to take the next step with an agency, then you can get in touch with us at Spring Digital. Or if you need more clarification, feel free to drop your questions in the comments section below. Otherwise, make sure you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about bringing your app or software idea to life. See you next time.